Now, the last reaction which we discussed is oxidation by MnO2. Okay, in oxidation by MnO2, it only oxidizes which all compound? Tell me. It only oxidizes which all compound? Allylic and benzylic. Very good. Right? Next thing. Okay, next is oxidation of side chain of aromatic compound. Third point, I think this is the third point. Oxidation of side chain of aromatic compound. Oxidation of side chain of aromatic compound. How to oxidize the side chain of aromatic compound? Now, what to do in this? Here you have a benzene ring, let's say. And if you use KMnO4, tell me students what will happen. Any idea? Alkaline KMnO4 on heating. Do you think what will happen? Tell me. Yes, we are going to start a new chapter after finishing this chapter. Abhinav. Yes, students, what will be the product? Any idea? KMnO4? Benzene? Okay, no reaction. Okay, benzene can't do anything. But if there is a benzene and there is a carbon, students, you won't see all this thing anywhere in textbook. So please pay attention here. If you see benzene ring and on this carbon, if you have either hydrogen, deuterium, tritium, triple bond, double bond, oxygen, any of these, and if you use KMnO4 in basic medium, all thing will be oxidized to carboxylic acid, or I want to say benzoic acid. Everything will be oxidized to benzoic acid. If it has a hydrogen, deuterium, tritium, double bond, triple bond, oxygen, anything. Example, let's say this is a benzene ring and benzoic acid. This is called as toluene. If you use KMnO4 in basic medium, what will happen, students? Quickly tell me what will happen. Toluene with KMnO4. I'm waiting for your answer. Very good, Aryan. Okay, benzoic acid. Fine. So students, not just this. Try to understand, I'm going to put so many reactions now. So here, if you have this type of compound also, CCH3, double bond, CH, CHN, any N number, and CH3, that will also give you benzoic acid. If you have something like this, benzene with C triple bond C and CH3, that will also give benzoic acid. If you have something like this, CH2, in place of that you have a Cl or NH2 or OH, anything, you will get benzoic acid. If you have something like C double bond O, CH2, N, CH3, this will also give benzoic acid. All these things will give you benzoic acid. Okay, then sir. Yes, but that will also give the same product. Okay, that will oxidize and give the CO, that COH will, means that will also give the benzoic acid in shock. No, I'm telling you that is a major product. No, major product will be the benzoic acid. Rest of this group will be broken down and they will be further oxidized. That is the different part. We will deal them separately. Okay, Archit? But the major product with the benzene ring will be benzoic acid. Example, but there is one case. Let's say you have this compound. What will happen with this? What will happen with this? No reaction, because there is no hydrogen attached to this carbon, so it can't oxidize. Wherever there is a hydrogen, there are the possibility or double bond or anything like that. But carbon-carbon single bond is present, it won't oxidize. Carbon-carbon double bond, it may oxidize to give you benzoic acid. But carbon single bond, no reaction. Okay? There are some more questions which can be asked. Let's say this is a benzene ring. And again, this is a benzene ring. If it oxidizes with KMnO4 in basic medium, what will be the product? Yes. Fine. So here the point, very good, Kingshuk, correct answer. Students, you need to think, there is a carbon present with a double bond. We won't touch this benzene ring, otherwise its aromaticity will break. We will break this compound like this, and the product obtained will be dicarboxylic acid. Is it clear? Okay, now students, oxidation means removal of electron. Okay, now a very interesting question which I am going to ask. Think, use your brain and tell me what will be the product. You need to use your brain and tell me the product. Don't simply write, sir, this is the product. There is some concept involved here. I am giving you a hint. Oxidation is removal of electron. Yes. Done? Okay, fine. Students, now I will tell you what will happen. This is a NO2. NO2 is a strong minus M group. NH2 is a strong plus M group. Plus M group will increase the density on this. Minus M will group decrease the density on this. If I use KMnO4, oxidizing agent means remove the electron. Now tell me, from which ring removal will be done? If I want money from someone, this means the other person should have money so that I can take. Which ring is having electron so that we can oxidize it? Which ring is having electron? NH ring with NH2 or ring with NO2? Ring with NH2 is having electron because NH2 is a plus M group. So it is having the electron density. So this will get oxidized. NO2 will remain as it is. NO2 will remain as it is, and this will give you the dicarboxylic acid on this. Is it clear, students? Yes or no? Next. Next is oxidation by V2O5. Oxidation by V2O5. Vanadium pentoxide. Now, students, here, this will oxidize your, you can say that, benzene ring also. If you have a benzene ring, you use V2O5. Yes, you need to increase the temperature to 500 degrees Celsius. What will happen? It will oxidize that and break this bond. Which bond it will break? I will tell you 1 minute. I will tell you which bond it will break. This is the bonds are like this. This bond will break and this bond will break. So the product will be COOH, COOH. Please remember, these are very specific question, and due to very high temperature, water will be removed because dicarboxylic acids are there. So heating effect of dicarboxylic acid, I discussed something about this also in class. Water will be removed due to very high temperature. Water will be removed and the product will be C double bond O, O, C double bond O and dash. Maleic anhydride will form. This is called as maleic acid. This is maleic anhydride. Maleic anhydride. Okay, students, this type of question is also asked. Okay, let me give you one question. If there are two benzene rings like this, tell me what will be the product? If there are two benzene ring and B2O5 on heating, yes. Done. What is element above carbon in final product? Above carbon is oxygen. Yes, B2O5, again, both ring will not break, only one ring will break and product will be maleic anhydride, means this anhydride will form. Is it clear, students? Yes or no? Okay, now, fine. Next is, so this B2O5 you need to remember. Okay, students, there is one more reaction which is generally asked. Just remember this reaction. If there is a naphthalene, okay, naphthalene is there, and you use K2Cr2O7, a strong oxidizing agent in acidic medium, or CrO3 in acidic medium, the product will be one benzene ring will remain as it is. One benzene ring will remain as it is. One benzene remain as it is. The other benzene will have O double bond O, double bond O, this. This will get oxidized like this. Okay, these are the benzylic positions where you get the oxygen. Okay, don't think much about this. This will be the product. Okay, now, students, the next one is Itard reaction. What is the Itard reaction? Write the heading Itard reaction, in which one of that we have already discussed. So write the heading Itard reaction, and very important reaction, Itard reaction. In Itard reaction, you take a toluene. You take toluene. Toluene with KMnO4 in basic medium and heating gives you carboxylic acid. I have already discussed. Okay, that I have already discussed. Sir, what other reactions are there? So this we have already discussed. This is here. If you use CrO2Cl2 also, Itard reaction, the reagent is CrO2Cl2. This will give you benzene with benzaldehyde. This is called as Itard reaction. Toluene with CrO2Cl2 will give this. Okay. CrO2Cl2 will give this product. Okay. Next will be sometimes. So, students, here you can say there is one more reaction which you write, which you can write here. If you use that in first step, Cr3CO hold twice oxygen. If this type of compound given to you in presence of water, then also benzaldehyde will form. Done, student? Any doubt in this? Okay, so the CrO2 Cl2, sometimes it return, it is in presence of carbon disulfide or something like that. But the important thing is CrO2 Cl2 must be there. Okay, so this is Itard reaction. Sometimes it is written in presence of CS2, carbon disulfide. So that gives you Itard reaction. And these three reactions of toluene are important. Okay, fine. So next is bromyl chloride. This is bromyl chloride. Okay, Vaibhav. Fine. So okay, here you can say that this is another reagent. No, not specific name given to this, but this reaction for when they were, there is a also, this is also a chromium anhydride formed by chromium acid. Okay, chromic, if you have a acids of chromium, if anhydride formed by that, that also give the benzaldehyde. Okay, anhydride is taken. Next is oxidation by HiO4. Fourth one, oxidation by HiO4. Okay, here you can write oxidation of HiO4. Moles of HiO4 require is equals to number of bonds broken down. So moles of HiO, here stoichiometry importance is there. Okay, example, if you have this compound, like it reacts with dicarbonyl, or it reacts with vicinal diol. So number of bond which will going to break, that will decide the moles of HiO4. Even it will react with C double bond O, COH, alpha hydroxycarbonyl. Even it will react with alpha hydroxycarbonyl. Okay, so here, what will be the reaction? We will see first that. So example, if you have this compound, let's say, what will happen? Let's say you have CH3, C double bond O, CH2, COH, H, CHOH, CS3. So students, what you need to do when HiO4 is used, here only one mole is needed. Why? Because we have one the system, CHOH, CHOH. Only one mole of HiO4 needed to break this bond. And when we break this bond, just add OH and OH on both sides. Just add OH and OH on both sides. Or see, when you add here, here OH and here OH, what you are going to get? CH3, C double bond O, CH2, CH, OH and OH. In next step, one carbon to our OH group, unstable, water will be removed. Minus H2O, CH3, C double bond O, CH2, CH2, C double bond OH. You will end up getting an aldehyde. Okay, this is the one product, and one product will form from this end also. One product will form from this end also. That will be the another product will be. I will draw the another product also. The another product will be also aldehyde, and that will be C double bond OH and CH3. So another product is this. How to know which bond will break? Whenever, because I told you HiO4 works for C double bond O, 1,2 dicarbonyl, vicinal diol, like that. Here you have 1,2 dicarbonyl. Can you see in the reactant? 1,2, you have vicinal diol in this case. So only that bond will break. Vicinal diol bond will break and give you with HIO4. This reaction will be used in glucose chapter, biomolecule chapter also. There I won't tell again, see, this is the mechanism or this is the process. I will directly say, okay, we have already discussed this in that place. So CS, so the product will be, one product is this, another product is this. So I will put them in a box. One product is this, and another one is this. Okay, one student has asked me over WhatsApp, like, sir, in ZN, I, by mistake in my notes, I have written, when ZN, HG and HCl used with conjugation, C double bond O is in conjugation with double bond. So both will get reduced. Who asked that question? Both bond will be reduced. Someone asked, I don't remember name. In my last class, when I explained the ZN, HG and HCl, when double bond is conjugation with C double bond O, then both will get reduced. I told this thing, but in the product, I have kept C double bond O. Please change that thing. Make it a complete alkene. Okay. Fine. There is one question. One of your friend has asked this question. Okay, let me give you this question. If you have CS3, C double bond O, COH, CS3. Could you tell me the product, students? Write by yourself. HIO4. Only one mole needed because one double bond is there. This type of system is there. Alpha hydroxy carbonyl. Students, product done. Done. Break this bond, CS3, C double bond O, HIO4 taken, right? So what will happen? Here you have, when you have C double bond O, so one will be the carboxylic acid, right? And how to make the product? Here you have, if I add OH here, so it will be a carboxylic acid, right? And if I add OH here also, what I'm going to get? CS3, OH and OH. So the product will be, not CS3, sorry. CS3 carbon. 1 minute. Another will be this. 2 carbon with OH and 1 CS3. So product will be, you can remove water from this. Here you have 1 hydrogen. So another product will be CS3, COH. Students, is it clear? Yes or no? Just break the bond, add OH. Break the bond, add OH. One product is this, one product is this. Okay, fine. Next part is oxidation of aldehyde and ketone. I think you must have learned this thing in school also, if they have started aldehyde and ketone chapter. So next part is oxidation of aldehyde and ketone. Oxidation of aldehydes and ketones. Aldehydes and ketones. Student, there is very, very important reaction. A is Tollens test. Tollens reagent or Tollens test. It is also used to test the aldehyde. And the Tollens reagent is, what is the Tollens reagent? Tollens reagent is ammonium hydroxide along with AgNO3. It is also called as ammonical silver nitrate. Okay, Weber, further ethanol will not get oxidized. I told you, this oxidizing HIO4 only work when there is on next carbon, on 2 carbons there are OO present, then only it will work. Is it clear, Weber? Like only 3 cases where I explained. 1,2-dicarbonyl, vicinal diol and alpha hydroxycarbonyl. Okay, I'm coming to this. Tollens reagent is this. Fine. What happens, students? There are 2 reactions. when you use alkyne with tolerance reagent, there will be very interesting reaction. NH4OH, AgNO3. Students, what will be the product? Can anyone tell me? Can anyone tell me the product? It's not difficult to predict. Okay, I will help you. First you try, then I will help you. No, no. Very good, Kingsho, correct answer. Kingsho, try the product. Okay, fine. So students, product form from the tolerance reagent will be product form from the tolerance. Okay, here the product is acid-base reaction. This is the acidic hydrogen. It will this will be removed, and since you have a Ag plus ion, so C triple bond C minus Ag plus. So you can write it like this also. It will form a covalent bond. So Ag. This is white PPT. White PPT will form. Okay, if someone asks, sir, what is the tolerance reagent, how it is prepared? So students, first, and how it is used for aldehyde and ketone, if this is the question. So I want to tell you, first we will write like what happens when you use, how it is prepared. Tolerance reagent is prepared by this reaction. If you want to prepare tolerance reagent, you need to have AgNO3 plus ammonical silver nitrate. The reaction will go and form AgOH plus NH4NO3, double decomposition reaction. In next step, your AgOH will react with, your AgOH will react again with ammonium hydroxide. And silver forms a very, very stable complex. In coordination compound, I will teach this thing. Silver form a very complex, stable complex with ammonia. This reaction is used to extract silver also from its ore, because silver forms a very stable complex with ammonia, and OH minus will form along with water. So this is called as tolerance reagent. When I'm writing NH4OH and AgNO3, this means the same compound is this, because when you mix them, this compound exist in complex form. Now I'm telling you how it will act like an oxidizing agent. If you use any aldehyde RCHO and you use tolerance reagent along with that, OH minus, okay, RCHO OH minus, here you have a tolerance reagent, and the product will be RCOO minus, because aldehyde is there, oxidizes to carboxylic acid. So, but since ammonia is present, you will get ammonium salt, RCOO minus and NH4 plus, because carboxylic acid with base gives a salt. Along with that, Ag will form, because aldehyde is oxidized, something has to reduce. The silver right now is in plus one oxidation state. This get reduced to silver zero. And this is giving you the mirror. This is called as silver mirror. This thing deposit, you know, over the inner wall of test tube. Along with that, ammonia liberated and water will form. So this Ag will get deposit on inner wall of test tube. This is called as silver mirror test. Okay, ketone does not give this test. Ketone does not give this test. Okay, now who? Both aromatic and aliphatic aldehyde gives this test. Aliphatic aldehyde. Both of them give this test. Aromatic and aliphatic aldehyde gives this test. Means both will become RCOO minus. Is it clear, students? Yes or no? Next reaction. Sir, is this the only reaction for aldehyde and ketone oxidation? No. Again, a very important reaction is called as Fehling's test. Fehling's test. In Fehling's test, these two are very important for your board exam also. First, you need to write the Fehling's reagent. What is the Fehling's reagent? Fehling's reagent is formed by two substances, A plus B. Okay, what is this A plus B? Don't write this in exam. Fehling is formed by two substances, A and B. You need to write A and B also. What is that? A is aqueous CuSO4. Very good, Stuti. A is aqueous CuSO4 and your B part is alkaline solution of sodium potassium tartrate. Alkaline solution of sodium potassium tartrate. This is a salt. Sodium potassium tartrate. Okay. So this is also called as Rochelle salt. What? R-O-C-H-E-L-L-E. Rochelle salt. Now, these two things are mixed and we call that thing as a Fehling reagent. Okay. So what happens, students? General reaction is aldehyde plus Fehling solution gives reddish brown PPT. Oxidation happens and give the why I'm emphasizing on in these two tests more, because they are the identification test of aldehyde and ketone. So aldehyde can be oxidized to something and you get the reddish brown PPT. What actually happens, I will write the equation. If you have RCHO, then copper ion will react. Why copper ion, sir? Because we have taken Fehling's reagent, aqueous CuSO4. Okay, so CuSO4 will give you copper ion plus OH minus ion 5 times when you balance it. Later, I think you in class 11th, you learned balancing also, how to balance the ionic equation. So I'm just directly writing balanced ionic equation. Aldehyde will oxidize to acid and your copper 2 plus will get reduced to Cu2O. This is called as cuprous oxide and it is red PPT, red precipitate. Okay, or sometimes it is written like reddish brown. So instead of writing red, write reddish brown PPT. Reddish brown PPT. Okay, reddish brown PPT. Now, sometimes it is written red PPT, sometimes it is written reddish brown, but I think we will assume that, okay, red PPT is also fine. So Cu2O will form and free water. So your copper will get reduced, aldehyde will get oxidized. So this is again a one reaction, which is very, very important. But there is one issue in this reaction. What issue? Not give test for aromatic aldehyde. This does not give test for aromatic aldehyde. Okay. This does not give test for aromatic aldehyde. So definitely these two are not going to, because we are discussing the oxidation of aldehyde. So these two reactions won't give the test of ketone. Is it clear? Now Fehling solution is over. So any doubt in this, students? Any doubt? Please remember that when we have a A and B part, we mix them in equal amount. Fehling solution A and Fehling solution B. This is called as Fehling solution A, Fehling solution B. Mix them in equal amount, then you will get this compound. Is it clear, students? Yes or no? If someone asks, sir, what is the salt of sodium and potassium tartrate, how it looks like? It looks like this. COO minus, HO minus, HO minus, HO COO minus, and they both, these both oxygen are going to attach with copper 2 plus. This is what Fehling solution is. It is used. Okay, that is why we have written directly copper 2 plus. And this thing forms due to the sodium and potassium tartarate, because we have a tartaric acid. This is a tartaric acid. If I put H and H everywhere, this is called as tartaric acid. Okay, so that will give you this test. Students, next text test is, okay, Schiff's test, third point. Next is Schiff's test. Schiff's test. This will be given by aldehyde only, RCHO only. Not aromatic aldehyde. Okay, RCHO. Here you have RCHO only. Here you have Schiff's base. Schiff's base. What is that? Rosaniline hydrochloride. This is the Schiff's base. Most of the time it will be given Schiff's base in the reaction. It is pink in color. When it is pink in color, now when it is passed through SO2, it become colorless. And this is called as Schiff's reagent. This is called as Schiff's reagent. Now if aliphatic aldehyde is taken, now if your aliphatic aldehyde, I have written here RCHO only. When here your aliphatic aldehyde taken, you will get the RCOOH that will oxidize to acid. And the pink color restored. Okay. Or pink color restored. So the point is, whenever colorless Schiff's reagent, first you make the Schiff's reagent using the Schiff's base. And when it is used with the aliphatic aldehyde, that will this color will start appearing again. And this give you this tells you the presence of aldehyde in your compound. Is it clear, students? Any doubt? Yes or no? Next is Benedict test. Next is fourth one. Fourth one is Benedict test. Benedict test. What is this Benedict test? It is an aqueous copper sulfate you take plus sodium citrate. Students, aliphatic aldehyde only. RCHO only for aliphatic aldehyde. It is difficult to oxidize the aromatic aldehyde. Okay, again, here you have RCHO. You take Benedict reagent. Benedict reagent, and the product will be RCO minus plus sodium citrate you take, aqueous copper sulfate you take. This will oxidize, aldehyde will get oxidized, and you will get Cu, because copper 2 plus you have taken, same thing as what you got in the Fehling solution, Cu2O will form. Red color will tell you, okay, there is a presence of an aldehyde. Both Fehling solution and Benedict test are similar. The only thing is the sodium salt are different. There you have a sodium and potassium salt of tartaric acid. Here you have a sodium salt of citric acid. That is the only difference. Is it clear, students?
Yes or no? Okay, students, there is one more reaction which we will discuss later also, but you can write here. Oxidation of ketone. How to oxidize methyl ketone? So write oxidation of ketones. In bracket, write methyl ketone. Okay, generally it is very difficult to oxidize ketone. Okay, we have discussed the oxidation of aldehyde, that is over. Now oxidation of ketone, generally it is very difficult to oxidize the ketone, but methyl ketone can be oxidized. Okay, sir, how we are going to oxidize the methyl ketone? So here you write iodoform reaction by iodoform reaction. Now this iodoform reaction is very, very important for your board exam point of view, for all the competitive exam. What is methyl ketone? First we need to understand what is methyl ketone. Methyl ketone is something like CH3 C double bond O dash. This is called as methyl ketone. Okay, students, now all the methyl ketones will give this test. And what happens during the reaction, we will see. So if methyl ketone is taken, the same reaction will come in carbonyl compound also. There I won't discuss that in detail because I am taking in this section, in oxidation section. So when there I will directly say refer this page. Now, what happens in methyl ketone oxidation? You write, reagent used is sodium hypoiodide. Reagent is sodium hypoiodide. Okay, sodium hypoiodide. Now here what we have, gives carboxylic acid having one carbon less than, gives carboxylic acid with one less carbon. Carboxylic acid will form with one less carbon. What is the general reaction? There will be a carbonyl compound. In presence of carbonyl compound, you can be having NaOI, sodium hypoiodide. You have this, or sometimes it will be written, most of the time it will be written like this. NaOH and I2, base with I2. Later I will explain this reaction also in B block chapter, not now. NaOH and I2 will give you RCOO. If this thing will get oxidized, ONa will form and CHI3. This is very, very important compound called as iodoform. Okay, this is called as iodoform. Now, this iodoform is yellow PPT. This tells the presence of ketone. So ketone can be oxidized, but only methyl ketone. Okay, so question can be asked, sir, what is the reaction for iodoform production? Iodoform reaction, you can write that NaOH when I2 is used, it will give you NaI plus NaOI plus H2O. This reaction is generally taught in E block chapter. There I will again emphasize on this reaction, and I will tell for all the halogens, reaction for all the halogen. But as of now, you can just write this. Any doubt, students? Any doubt in this? Okay, so one question if I ask, see, if question is, what will be the product? What will be the product of this reaction? Quickly write the product. Will it give iodoform test? Will it give iodoform test? Question is this. Will it give iodoform test? Methyl ketone is needed. Methyl ketone.
Will it give iodoform test?
Okay, fine. Student, it will not give iodoform test. Okay, it won't give iodoform test. Fine.
No reaction. Why there is no methyl ketone? To have iodoform test, there will be methyl ketone. Sir, if someone is thinking, sir, could you please tell us the mechanism?
What will happen?
So the mechanism is, let's say this is a methyl ketone, CH3COOR. This methyl ketone when reacts with NaOI, I've written. So NaOI can be written as OI minus. OI minus is a nucleophile as well as base. Since I told you methyl ketone is needed, it will take the acidic hydrogen. It will take this hydrogen. Once it will attack on this hydrogen, you will get CH2 minus C double bond OR. In next step, since you have taken I2,
this negative will attack on this vacant orbital of I, and this I minus will be removed.
Product will be highly reversible reaction, no doubt. So product will be R C double bond O CH2I. In next step,
what will happen?
The same thing will repeat again and again. Again, there is acidic hydrogen, same thing will repeat, and the product form will be RCOOCi3. Do you remember, students? Do you remember what is this? Few days back, we discussed something about this substrate. Which type of reaction this substrate gives? Few days back, we discussed RC double bond OCi3. Which type of reaction this will give if there is OH minus ion? Any idea? Forgot. It is a strong minus I group. It is an impure carbonyl. Impure carbonyl reaction is? Characteristic reaction of impure carbonyl. Hey, characteristic reaction of impure carbonyl. CH3COOCl, impure carbonyl, which type of reaction it gives? Very good, Archit. Impure carbonyl characteristic reaction. Pure carbonyl gives nucleophilic addition. Impure carbonyl gave? Very good, Kingshok. SN2TH mechanism. SN2TH. This will go, Ci3 will be removed. Product will be RCOOH along with CBr3 minus or Ci3 minus. And this is a colorless solid. Fine. Then, okay, we are not colorless solid. Here it is yellow solid, Ci3. If it is a Br3, I will tell you later. It is a yellow solid. Okay, once it takes the hydrogen, what happens in next step? This is acid. In next step, it will take hydrogen from water. You can say there is a water taken. So in next step, it will form CHI3. It is a yellow solid. So this is the mechanism of iodoform reaction. But so that is why I told you, you use methyl ketone. Is it clear? This is a yellow solid, okay? So students, some people ask, sir, is it only possible for iodoform? Does it not give chloroform or bromoform? Yes, it will give chloroform, bromoform also. CHCl3 is chloroform, colorless liquid. That is why we don't use it. If it is CHI3, it is colorless solid. CHBr3, it is colorless solid. CHBr3 is colorless solid, but we are interested in some color. That is why we use iodoform. We use iodine because CHI3 is yellow solid. That is why we prefer
iodoform reaction. Okay, rate is same for all the three. Which is the RDS step? Student, RDS step is this. Why I said rate is same for all these? Because RDS step is this. Rate determining step is this. First step. Because this is very less acidic hydrogen, which it has been removed. So, our generation of nucleophile, generation of C minus is a RDS step. Is it clear, students? Is it clear? Any doubt? Okay, sir, which all groups? Now, few other groups also give this test. Student, first tell me, did you understand or not? Iodoform reaction. Yes or no? Yes? Okay, fine. See, which all groups can give? Your methyl ketone, CH3COR, this is the most important. But even this also gives this test, COHR. Sir, why it gives test? Because, can anyone tell me why this reagent also gives 2-degree alcohol also give iodoform test? Can anyone tell me why? Why? Okay, fine. Students, very good, Archit. Correct answer. It will oxidize first by NaOI and it will convert into methyl ketone only. So even this will give the positive test. Okay, fine. Anything else? CH3COOH. This also gives positive test because methyl give. Sir, this is aldehyde. How this will give test? Yes, this will give test because there is a methyl group present next to C double bond O. Next to C double bond O methyl group present, this will also give test. Though it's aldehyde, no worries. Okay. Will this give the test? Just check. Here you have taken 2-degree. But here you have taken 1-degree only. Okay, so student, there is a methyl group present here. This thing, here you have, see, even this will oxidize first to this state. Even this will also first oxidize to this state. So this will also give the iodoform test. Means don't think directly carboxylic acid will form. This will oxidize to this state first. It will also give iodoform test. But impure carbonyl does not give iodoform test, like this, G with a lone pair. This is called as impure carbonyl. This won't give iodoform test. Is it clear, students? Or haloform? This is also called as haloform. Any doubt? Yes or no? Okay. So students, there is one interesting part here. Write one thing. Okay. There is one more thing. If you have this compound, CH3, C double bond O, CH2, C double bond O, CH3. Will this give iodoform test? Student, think. First think about the mechanism and then write. Do you think this will give iodoform test? Think about mechanism and tell.
Fine. Students does not give iodoform test. Sir, what? Sir, why?
Okay.
Why? Students, I told you in mechanism, base is attacking on this hydrogen. Base is attacking on this hydrogen. Do you think there is one good option for base to attack in this case? Do you think there is very one good place to attack for base? Active methylene group. Is this hydrogen more acidic? Is this hydrogen more acidic? If I'm talking about hydrogen number A and hydrogen number B, which is more acidic? Which is more acidic thing? I taught you the active methylene group thing. Which hydrogen is more acidic, A or B? A is more acidic hydrogen. Why? Can anyone tell me why? Why A is more acidic hydrogen? Why not B? Why A is more acidic hydrogen? Think. Okay, sir, I don't know. So if you don't know, then draw. If you don't know, then draw the two states where the hydrogen is removed. If you don't know, then draw and check. Tell me which carbanion is more stable. Tell me which carbanion is more stable. If this is compound one and this is compound two, which is more stable? There is a resonance between two oxygen. There is resonance with two oxygen. It has resonance just with one oxygen. This negative has resonance just with one oxygen. So it is more stable. Yes, CH. Is it clear, students? Yes or no? So if it is more stable, this hydrogen is more acidic. So attack won't happen on this. So what condition is there? Carbon should have more acidic hydrogen. In methyl ketone, that methyl of ketone should have more acidic hydrogen. Then only haloform reaction will take place. The methyl of ketone should have more acidic hydrogen. Then only you will get haloform reaction. Otherwise, it does not give haloform reaction. Okay. So, methyl group of what you can write as a note, methyl group should have more acidic hydrogen. Methyl group should have more acidic hydrogen. Then only you will get haloform test. Then only haloform test is given. Okay, otherwise attack will happen on this. Your methyl group won't participate also. Any doubt, students? Just last line related to the haloform. Rate of I2 is equals to Br2 is equals to Cl2. No change. Because they are not involved in RBS step. Any doubt? Fine. So students, we have done so many questions in this. Now let us move to the next part of the same thing. Oxidation of alkanes, last part. Then we will start aromatic and compound chapter. Last part of this chapter, oxidation of alkanes. So it's not needed to cover this because alkane chapter you learnt in last year, but still I'm covering so that those who missed that part can. First one is complete oxidation. First of all, I told you that alkanes are very, very less reactive. So complete oxidation means your CnH2n+2 reacts with oxygen. Okay, I will write a balanced chemical equation. Those who don't know, this is the balanced chemical equation. O2 gives N times of CO2 plus N plus 1 times of H2O. So this is a balanced chemical equation. Okay, any doubt? 2N
N and plus 1, right? Balanced chemical equation plus energy. This is one oxidation. Now this is a complete oxidation. So what is incomplete oxidation then? There is something called as incomplete oxidation also, that you know that carbon will form or carbon monoxide will form. So that is the incomplete oxidation. I will write that, let's say methane gas reacts with oxygen gas in a limited amount, gives carbon solid, black, incomplete oxidation, plus 2H2O, liquid. These are the two oxidations of reactions of alkanes, which you all know. But someone says, sir, I want controlled oxidation. If we want to have a controlled oxidation, there is a third reaction, right? Controlled oxidation, less important, but still this is the oxidation technique used for alkane. Here you have a regulated supply of oxygen. So you have CHHHH, MO2O3, when you heat it, you have only controlled oxidation. 2OH will be converted into 2 hydrogen will be converted into 2OH, and you will stop, you will just get aldehyde. Don't think about acid. You will get aldehyde. So this is the controlled oxidation. Just very specific example, molybdenum oxide is used. I am moving to the next reaction, chemical oxidation. Okay. Now the last one, last reaction. Sir, can KMnO4 also oxidize if someone thinks? So yes, KMnO4 also oxidize, but right fourth one, chemical oxidation. How it will oxidize, we will see. If you have possible only with those alkane having 3-degree hydrogen, three-degree hydrogen can be oxidized by alkaline KMnO4. Please remember this part. If you have this type of alkane, 3-degree hydrogen, if you use alkaline KMnO4 also, it will oxidize it to alcohol. Okay. Yes. And there is one more reaction. But okay, fine. That's it. These are the general reaction. You can write one more reaction, that is methane reacts with oxygen in presence of copper at 577 Kelvin, you will get methanol. This is also a preparation of methanol with the help of methane using copper. With this, this chapter is over. Okay, if there is some reaction which are left, that will be covered in some other chapters. I think mostly all reaction I have already taken. Today I will be sharing two worksheets, one for reduction, one for oxidation. Please don't forget to complete. And students, in last class I shared the worksheet for substitution. I extended its time also, but still I can't see many submission. Substitution reaction I gave you long back, but still you people have not submitted your answer. This is very, very disappointing. You need to submit your homework, otherwise there is no point. So how many of you have done the homework but not submitted for substitution? Tell me, last time I gave you the homework for substitution reactions. How many of you have done but not submitted? Tell me, Amrita, who else? Only one. Okay, fine. So students, please submit it after the, I will extend the date if needed, but you need to complete the homework. And those who have submitted, I have the list. So in PTC, I will tell all those things. Those who have submitted and those who have not submitted. Next is, let us start a new chapter. Okay, students, see, we have done almost many of the reactions we have already covered. Most of the reaction we have covered,
in the reaction mechanism, okay, and in whatever mechanisms we have discussed. Now this is the aromatic compound. Sir, why you are taking this chapter? Because if I don't take this chapter, every chapter is incomplete. Why? Because if you see in NCERT, there is a alcohol and a phenol. So phenol itself a very different compound. It is not showing reaction like alcohol. So which type of reaction it shows? We will see in this aromatic compound chapter. So, and it is very important for your JE point of view or any competitive exam point of view. Okay, you won't see any chapter like aromatic compound in your school textbook, but yes, you must find aniline, you must find phenol, you must find benzene, something like that. So those all will come under this section. So here it is very, very important to understand this chapter. Okay, students, after today's class, I will be sharing one PDF with you. Okay, that PDF will have a aromatic compound related things. So please go through that PDF also. That has a very, you can say that, important topics and so many examples also. So that the PDF you can use. Okay, now students, first I will start with the aromatic compound. Here it is a cyclic unsaturated compound are two types. Cyclic unsaturated compounds are two types. Cyclic unsaturated means which have a cycle and double bond or triple bond like that. So they are of two types. One is the, or instead of saying two type, they will have a three type. One is aromatic. One is anti-aromatic. Anti-aromatic. And one is non-aromatic. Non-aromatic. Okay, students, first tell me one thing. Last year, did you learn how to check whether something is aromatic, something is anti-aromatic, and something is non-aromatic? Yes or no? Did you learn that? Huckel's rule? Yes, yes. Yes, so you have learned that. So I won't be discussing that in detail. Okay? So Huckel's rule, you all have learned. So for anti-aromatic, the only difference is okay, what are the primary conditions? They should be cyclic. They should be planar, cyclic, planar. Okay, fine. Cyclic compound, planar, or ring atoms. All atoms should be either sp2, all atoms should have either sp2 or sp hybridization. sp3 is not allowed, otherwise the ring will not be planar. Complete cyclic delocalization. Okay, those who are new, for them I am going to tell this again. And complete cyclic delocalization, what else? Fourth one is should follow 4n plus rule. Should follow 4n plus 2 rule. 4n plus 2 pi electron rule of Huckel. 4n plus 2 pi electron rule of Huckel. This is highly stable. And sixth one is burns with black smoky flame. Okay. Now, aroma, that is have a fragrance, smell, okay, so that is having aroma. And the last one is diamagnetic in nature. They all are diamagnetic. Students, did you learn this last year? All these 7-8 points for aromatic compound? Yes or no? These should be the necessary condition for any aromatic compound. Necessary condition, or you can say, yes, these are the characteristics. They are highly stable, burns with. Necessary conditions are these. Which one? These four. Cyclic, planar, complete cyclic, follow 4N plus 2 rule. Okay, then next is anti-aromatic. In anti-aromatic, first rule, second rule, third rule are same. But in fourth rule, it differ. It has 4N pi electron. 4N pi electron. Where N is equals to 1, 2, 3, 4, whatever.
highly unstable. This is highly unstable. Highly unstable. And the last one is paramagnetic in nature. They are paramagnetic. Aromatic compounds are aromatic compounds are diamagnetic. Non-aromatic compounds are non-planar. First of all, the primary condition. They are non-planar. Because of any reason, not just sp3 or whatever, because of any reason, if it is a non-planar, we will say it is a non-aromatic compound. Okay, it shows property of alkenes and alkynes. It won't show property of aromatic compound. Is it clear, students? Let us do some examples. These are the conditions. I think you must have written all these things. Let us do some questions. If you have this compound, students, please tell me whether it's aromatic or not. Is this compound aromatic? Tell me fast. Is this compound aromatic? Tell me whether they are aromatic, anti-aromatic, non-aromatic. This is compound 1, this is compound 2, and this is compound 3. Okay. Fine. Done. Students, few more questions I want to give you. So fourth one is, okay, this one. And fifth one is, fine, there could be many questions. Okay, fourth one. Fifth one will be, done. So students, this is fifth. 1 minute. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Done. Anyone who has done all the 9 questions? Okay, fine. Fine. A 8-membered ring with this. Okay, quickly tell me answer of this. Done. Deepa. Yes. Okay, fine. students, I think you have already done just a quick recap. This is anti-aromatic. This is anti-aromatic 4N plus 2 pi electrons. Okay. This is, what is the answer for second question? What is the answer for second question? Tell me. Here you have a double bond. Second question. Hey, you have done. Tell me fast. Second question. Okay. Second question is non-aromatic. First of all, you can't say it as aromatic because there is not some complete cyclic delocalization. First of all, there is not complete cyclic delocalization. Because here delocalization breaks. Double, single, single lone pair. How you can say it's a complete cyclic delocalization? And second, why non-aromatic? Because this carbon is sp3. Okay. Hope you understood this. Yes, next one. Third one. So this compound is actually, second one is non-planar. Third compound. Oh my God. This means you people have not learned it properly last time. You have not learned it properly. Just see the lone pair delocalization. Lone pair, single, double. Complete cyclic delocalization. Cyclic delocalization means double, single, double will repeat. So complete cyclic delocalization, number of electron pair. Two electron. 6 electron. Aromatic compound. 6 electrons are involved in delocalization. 2 from nitrogen, 2 from carbon, 4 from carbon. No. Yes. N lone pair not participating. Why? Why it won't participate? It will participate. No. Okay, fine. Always remember, this is very less basic. This compound is very less basic in nature because this is an aromatic compound. No, in furan also oxygen is delocalized. Always remember, here you have nitrogen present, the lone pair is in delocalization with the double bond. Wherever possible, okay, fine. If you are comparing it with pyridine, that is a different thing. In pyridine, nitrogen lone pair is not in delocalization. Why? Because there is already a complete cyclic delocalization. There, this lone pair is not in delocalization. But not in this case. Here lone pair will be in delocalization. So it is aromatic compound. 2, 2, 2, 6 electrons. Is it clear to all of you? Here it is also aromatic. But these 2 electrons are not delocalized. So we will count only these other 6. Is it clear? Yes or no? Okay, next. Fourth one, complete cyclic delocalization. Yes, fourth one, aromatic, anti-aromatic, non-aromatic. What? Gayatri, correct answer. Vaibhav, wrong answer. Okay, one minute. Yes. There you have 4N plus 2 pi electron. Yes. Sorry, Vaibhav correct. Gayatri wrong. And rest everyone is correct. Stuti, check again. This compound is aromatic. 2 electrons are in conjugation, only 2 electrons, but complete cyclic delocalization, aromatic. Any doubt? Do this 5th one. Fifth one, Okay, whenever the rings are attached with a single bond, we will count the individual rings. We will count the electrons of individual rings when they are attached with a single bond. So here you have 6 electron, here you have 6 electron, aromatic. And all are planar, everything is there. What about 7th one? Yes, Deepa, correct. Pitting reaction forms biphenyl. 7th one. Seventh one, Ruchita, correct answer. Archit, correct answer. Okay, so here what will be the answer? Fine. So here we will say 2, 1, 1. Total 6 electrons. 6 electron in delocalization, complete cyclic delocalization, aromatic. Tell me answer for this. Done. Fine. So, okay, fine. I'm asking for, okay, 8th one. What is the answer of 8th one? 8th one. Students, 8th group, okay, fine, I will tell you. 8th one will become like this. Oxygen is more electronegative. Electron will be pulled by this and it will get positive. Okay, sorry. Now see, I forgot to put one dash there. Now tell me. Now tell me whether it's aromatic, anti-aromatic or non-aromatic. Okay, fine. So answer is aromatic. Aromatic. Yes, it's not second is different. They are the resonating structures. Understood? It will shift like that. When electron will shift like that, we will say it's a aromatic compound. It forms aromatic compound. So whenever these type of questions are given, you will count the rings, you will count the number of electrons in a ring. Then for the second one, it is benzene. Second one, it is benzene. No. Second one is not in delocalization at all. Because this carbon has nothing. It's not complete delocalization, Weber. You have just lone pair on one atom. Okay. Yes, students, 9th one. Whenever rings are attached together, we will add total number of double bonds. When the rings are attached, we will add total number of double bonds. What will be the answer? Fine. So this will be the aromatic. Why? Because total electrons are 10 electrons are in delocalization. 4n plus 2. What I have left the two questions. Question number 10th I have left and question number 6. So students, there is an exception in question number 10th and 6. Could I move to next slide? I have not discussed question number 10th and question number 6. It seems like question number 6 is. In the question number 6, it seems like it is aromatic compound, but actually it is non-aromatic. Why? What happens in question number 6? What happens in question number 6? This is double bond, this is double bond. Here there are hydrogens present. Here you have hydrogens, which are creating a repulsion. These two hydrogen creates a repulsion. You know, it is called as transangular strain. There is some angular strain created by these hydrogens. This repulsion is there. So what happens? They make this ring non-planar. They make this thing non-planar. And once it becomes non-planar, even you have complete delocalization or whatever, the compound is non-aromatic. Any doubt? Now the 8-membered thing. This is question number 6. For question number 10, the 8-membered thing generally exists as this. The 8-membered thing generally exists like this. Okay, this is what form? This is a tub shape. This 8-membered ring exists in a tub shape. Okay, there is a double bond. I will draw a double bond like this. There is a double bond like this. So no delocalization, because for that ring should be planar. Okay, this is a non-planar. So no cyclic delocalization. Tub shape. Non-planar, tub shape. So these exceptions you need to remember. And here you have a pure double bond. Here you have a pure double bond. Pure double bond means it is not in delocalization. So it is non-aromatic. Is it clear, students? Non-aromatic. Is it clear? Okay. Now, if there are, one student has asked. Okay. Now see, if this is, sir, in the 5th question, if one ring is aromatic, yes, I am coming to that. Wait. Someone has asked this question, wait. Now, what will be the answer for this? I am coming to your question. What will be the answer for this? If there are two rings are like this. Aromatic, non-aromatic, anti-aromatic. Aromatic, sure. Fine. Students, whenever the rings are connected by the two double bonds, when our ring is connected with double bond, we will shift double bond some to some of the atom, like we have done in that question. When ring next atom means when atom of the ring is attached with double bond, we shift the double bond and check whether it's aromatic or not. Here also this is attached with double bond, I will shift the atom. So you are going to get something like this. Negative and positive. Now tell me, what about the two rings? You can separately check. What about the two rings? Done? Fine. So if you see, what about this ring? Aromatic or anti-aromatic? 2-electron. Aromatic. What about this ring? Are you not able to imagine? This is the situation. One ring is like this. One is like this. There is a positive, there is a negative. Double bond. This is a aromatic because 2n electron, complete cyclic delocalization, 2 electrons, aromatic. But here it is anti-aromatic. So whenever such situation arises, the overall compound is non-aromatic. We don't say either aromatic, non-anti-aromatic. We will directly say the compound is non-aromatic. Is it clear? Whenever you have this situation, both compounds are aromatic, then only we will say aromatic compound. Both rings should be aromatic. Example, one more question. If you have this thing, a very interesting question. If you have double bond, double like this. Yes, tell me fast whether the compound is aromatic or anti-aromatic or non-aromatic. You need to shift electrons such that you get aromatic compound. Try to get aromatic compound. Shift electron in that way. Students, I am unsharing my screen for one minute. I will show you something very interesting. Yes. Okay. Fine. Students, can you see my screen? Can you see my screen? Yes or no? Okay, fine. So here, if you have this type of situation, the question which I have given is this. I am going to share this PDF with you. There are a lot of examples given in aromatic and anti-aromatic. Everything can't be covered in class. So I will be sharing this PDF with you. But the question which I have shared just now is this. 1 minute. The question which I have shared just now is this. Okay. There are two possibilities. One possibility is the electron will be shifted like this. Then both ring will be aromatic. One possibility is this, that one become anti-aromatic, other become anti-aromatic. But we will ignore the second option. Because we are getting one option where both are aromatic. So the overall system is aromatic. But here in the previous question, overall system is non-aromatic. Because you are not getting anything where you are getting both aromatic rings. So please underline, please write this line. In such type of system, it can never be anti-aromatic. And such type of system is aromatic, then both rings must be aromatic after displacement of double bond. Okay? So students, there are lot of hundreds of examples given in this PDF, which I will be sharing after the class, and you can go through this properly. Okay, fine. So this is all about the aromaticity of any compound. Here I want to just tell you one more thing, like azulenes. What are azulenes? You can see here. Okay, in a monocyclic compound, there are so many. See, these are. Azulenes are like this. 1 minute. Yes. So 4 pi electrons. These examples I have already taken in class. These examples are over. Now, what are the azulene? These type of rings. Okay. Non-pi bond in monocyclic. You can see that there are so many pi bonds in a monocyclic compounds. So here you have is isomer of naphthalene. So if you have this isomer, you shift the electron and you check, there are the resonating structures. Okay, so here, if you have this type of compound, then what will happen? All those things you can see here. Okay, like one question is asked, generally asked, like generally whatever aniline, here you see, there is, this is also a compound 12 pi. This is anti-aromatic, you count the number of double bond, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Anti-aromatic. This is also anti-aromatic. This compound is also anti-aromatic. Why? So here 2 to 4 to 6 to 8 to 10 to 12. Why it is anti-aromatic? Any idea? Yes. Because what happens, students? This, can anyone tell me? Why this carbon, why this compound is anti-aromatic? This one. Count number of double bond, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, and 14.
So students, what happens? We don't count this double bond at the center because it is not present in delocalization. Your double bond at center is not present in delocalization. Actually, electron will have a delocalization in periphery of the ring. What is the periphery of the ring? This part. Electron will remain in delocalization in this periphery of the ring. Like, 1 minute, this part. It will remain in delocalization on periphery of the ring. So this electrons is not in delocalization. That makes this compound anti-aromatic. Is it clear? Yes or no? Okay, so fine, one more question and the last question related to this topic. So if I take this example, fine, best, I think it's clear, but if you like want to take one more example, I will take it here. Fine, this is the last thing. If you have this, would you comment whether it's aromatic or anti-aromatic or non-aromatic or whatever? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Tell me fast. Aromatic or non-aromatic? Think fast and tell me. Very good, Kingshu, correct answer. Sinchen, correct answer. Fine. Ruchita, correct answer. Students, I told you, electron will delocalize on the periphery of the ring. Electron will delocalize on the periphery of the ring. This double bond will not be included in delocalization. So that this compound is aromatic. Is it clear? I hope we have taken. Sir, then naphthalene, even though as a double bond is in between. No, that is different thing. In naphthalene, if you have this, 1, 2, okay, fine. That is the different thing. Here, this is a part of aromatic ring. Okay. Here in naphthalene, we don't say, because this is a part of aromatic ring. Okay, but as the ring increases, the number of ring increases, then this thing we say this is non-aromatic, or means then it is not included because there is a complete delocalization and extended delocalization. Fine. Now, next is formation reaction in which aromatic compounds are formed. So, write the heading, formation of aromatic compound. 1 minute, students. Okay. Formation of aromatic compound. What all formation involved for aromatic compound? Students, can you please tell me what will be the product? Yes. Br with aqueous AgNO3. Quickly write the product. Done. I will tell you. Here you have the 7, 8, the same ring here. But if you see, this forms a aromatic compound. If Br is removed, if Br minus is removed, there will be a positive charge. And this forms an aromatic compound. Plus NO3 minus. And that is how AgBr is formed. TPT. So this reaction is how, this is how the aromatic compounds are formed. Okay. Because you always remember, students, sometimes this is a highly stable compound, that is why Br is removed. This is a highly stable compound, that is why Br is removed. Okay. Now, if you have this this diagram or this reaction, tell me what will be the product? Aqueous AgNO3. What will be the product? Done. Name I will write 7-bromo-cyclo-hepta-1,3,5-triene. 1,3,5-triene. Yes. Yes, students, what will be the product? Very good, Gayatri, correct answer. Very good. No reaction. Because if you form the product, because if you remove the Br minus, a compound which is going to form is something like this. And this is anti-aromatic compound, very, very unstable. So there is no reaction. This compound won't form, this reaction doesn't happen. Is it clear, students? Is it clear? What will be the product? This question we have already done. What will be the product? Quickly tell me. What will be the product? Yes. Think this reaction we have already discussed. Okay, I'll help you a little bit. Very good, Deepa, correct answer. This reaction we discussed in reaction of metal with active hydrogens. With active hydrogens. Fine, done. Reaction of metal with active hydrogens. Done. Fine, students, with this hydrogen become highly active, because once it will go, the compound will be an aromatic compound. So this hydrogen prefers to leave with sodium, and the compound which is going to form is aromatic compound. Is it clear? So this is how the aromaticity leads some reaction, aromaticity of compound. If you have this type of reaction, what will happen? There are BF3. Now BF3 will say, okay, I can accept the halogen. BF3 is electro deficient. So F minus will go and form this compound. When F minus will go, the compound form will look like this. Compound form will look like this. Positive and positive. This is a aromatic compound. You can count number of electrons, 2 to 4 to 6. 6 electrons complete cyclic delocalization. Planar molecule. All the 4 conditions are satisfied here. Okay. Planar, complete cyclic delocalization and 4N plus 2 and cyclic compound. So plus BF4 minus. 2 molecules of BF4 minus will form. Is it clear, students? Yes or no? Even if your Kolbe electrolysis reaction also, if you remember, that also goes in forward direction because of the formation of, this is also Kolbe electrolysis. This is also one way to prepare a benzene ring. Preparation of aromatic compounds. Okay, fine. There is one more reaction which we have already discussed in some of the chapter. In last part of substitution reaction, we have discussed this reaction also. If you have this type of compound, Br, single bond. If you have this type of compound with zinc and heating effect, what will happen, students? Remember, can you imagine what will happen here? Yes, Br will leave, zinc will give its electron. What will happen? Br will leave the compound, zinc will give its electron to this atom. So Br will leave the compound and zinc will give its electron. Can I directly write like this? That what will happen? I can directly write it like this instead of drawing the zinc and all. Instead of drawing this, I can directly write Br will give its bond to this. This bond will fall like this, and this Br will leave. And you will get a very interesting molecule. This is also a preparation technique of benzene, a naphthalene. This. Is it clear? This is also a reaction. When I told you, when there is a conjugation attack take place such that we will see like in which case the compound become more stable. Now we are coming to the chemical properties. Chemical properties of aromatic compound. Chemical properties of aromatic compound. What all chemical properties we have in our in this? So first you are trying to understand what is aromaticity. What is aromaticity, students? It is the property due to which compound is highly stable. This is the property of an aromatic compound, due to which compounds are highly stable. So here you can write one thing, that the property due to which cyclic unsaturated compounds are thermodynamically more stable. The property due to which cyclic unsaturated compounds are thermodynamically more stable. Then expected one. Whatever you expect, it is more stable than that compound. Okay. So here you can say the property due to which highly unsaturated compound behave like a saturated compound. Due to this reason, they behave like saturated compound. Due to this, they behave like saturated compound. And saturated compounds have some characteristic property, that is substitution reaction. So they also give substitution reaction. So you're right, gives substitution reaction. They also give substitution reaction. Because this is a property of saturated compound. But if these compounds are giving this thing, this means they are behaving like a saturated one. Example, you see that if you have a haloalkane, if you have, let's say, CH3Br plus nucleophile, CH3Br plus nucleophile, it gives you CH3NU, substitution reaction. But unsaturated compounds give addition reaction. Unsaturated compound give addition reaction. So here the benzene also, if you see benzene in presence of electrophile, benzene in electrophile also give the substitution reaction, and you get a benzene with electrophile plus H minus, plus H plus. Okay, this also gives substitution reaction. Now students, there are two ways to tell the substitution reaction. There are two ways to tell nucleophilic substitution. There are two ways. Even the substitution is divided into two types. I have already discussed those two types. One is electrophilic and one is nucleophilic substitution. One is nucleophilic aromatic substitution. Nucleophilic aromatic substitution. Okay, and this is electrophilic. I will directly write EAS, electrophilic aromatic substitution. Okay, now as I already told you students this part, that nucleophilic aromatic substitution is not favorable. Why nucleophilic aromatic substitution is not favorable? Because if you have some this compound, if you have a normal benzene ring and nucleophile will attack, then nucleophile has to leave H minus with nucleophile. Nucleophile has to form NU plus H minus. Now the problem is this H minus is highly unstable. So nucleophilic aromatic substitution is not favorable. Not so favorable. Either it form H minus, or if there is a some other, okay, here you have hydrogen, right? If there is some other nucleophile that will have a double bond, see, this is one case. Otherwise, if you have this compound, Cl, and nucleophile, why this reaction is not favorable? Tell me. Why this reaction is also not favorable? Any idea? Chlorine. No. You can say that, sir, this will form this compound, a nucleophile plus Cl minus. Why this reaction is not favorable? Any idea? There is chlorine. If you see, if I draw it like this, chlorine, double bond. Why this reaction is not favorable? The reason is, it is very difficult to remove Cl from the benzene ring because it has a double bond characteristic. So this bond is having a double bond characteristic. Double bond characteristics. That is why difficult to break. That is why both of these reactions, here H minus is unstable. So in any case, nucleophilic substitutions are not favorable. These are not favorable. So the only reactions which we are going to discuss is electrophilic aromatic substitution. This we are going to discuss. There is a benzene ring, there is an electrophile that will give you the substitution of electrophile plus H plus. This we are going to discuss. Is it clear, students? Now, so we have discussed two reactions of nucleophilic substitution. Already we have covered that part.
reactions of nucleophilic aromatic substitution. Remember, when NO2 is there or a strong electron withdrawing group is present. Remember, yes or no? If a strong electron withdrawing group is present, then the reaction will, electron withdrawing group is present at ortho and para position, then only reaction will proceed. Now let us move to the next reaction. If there is NH2, okay, and there is an electrophile, what will be the product, students? Quickly tell me. What will be the product? Electrophile in presence of NH2. This you have learned last year. Yes, plus M group and electrophile. No idea. Yes. Very good, Gayatri. Yes, students, please answer. Okay, how many of those who know the answer, please write your answer. What will happen when electrophile is taken to this? Where it will attack? Okay, if I ask you the simple question like this. If there is a, this you learned last year. If electrophile is taken, what will be the product? Toluene. Toluene with electrophile. Yes. Very good. Ortho and para position. So students, this you know that you learned it last year that, okay, so I will generalize this thing. I will generalize this thing. Whenever there is a benzene ring, whenever there is benzene ring and G is present, it will be, now there are two cases, it will be ortho-para directing. It will be ortho-para directing. Like what all groups? F plus M plus I groups, then it is ortho-para directing. If G is plus M plus I, if G is plus M plus I, then it is ortho-para directing. And if G is meta directing, G will be meta directing if it is minus M minus I. Yes or no? Yes or no? The reason is quite obvious. The reason is obvious why it is like this. Students, if it is like this, NH2. If this is NH2, what is going to take place? Yes. There is a NH2, you put electrophile you put, what will happen? If you see this electron will shift here. Okay, try to understand. Your electrophile will wants to attack either on, when the, due to the delocalization, what will happen? Due to delocalization, what will happen? This negative will appear here, or negative will appear here, or negative will appear here. So electrophile wants to attack on these or only these positions. Example, many people explain it like this also. If it will attack on para position, let's have an attack on para position, then I will explain. See, if this electrophile attacks on para position, so electron will shift here and it will attack on para position. So what will be the product? The product will be RNH2, electrophile, positive charge, double bond, NH2, double bond. This is the case. In next step, it will delocalize. This is called as uranium ion. This is called as
arenium ion. So it will again delocalize, and the negative will come on this carbon, NH2, positive, lone pair, and double bond are like this, and H and electron. Now students, your positive is getting complete octet. Students, do you remember I told you this is a highly stable situation? This is highly stable situation when the positive is getting a complete octet by the lone pair. So this is octet completion. Octet completion step. That is why it is highly stable. And that is why attack is favored on para position. So what will happen? Lone pair will be donated. And the product which you are going to get is something like this. NH2 plus NH2 plus this electrophile hydrogen. A very, very stable, highly stable intermediate. Highly stable intermediate. This is the reason why electrophile attacks on para position. The same thing is applicable when you draw the attack on ortho position also. When you draw, same thing is applicable for ortho position. Same is applicable for ortho position. Applicable for ortho position. But if you do the same thing for meta position, you won't get this ion at all. You won't get this ion where the octet of all atoms are complete. You won't get positive charge on this atom. So that octet completion can take place. That is why these are orthopara-directing. Plus M are always orthopara-directing. So students, I don't think that minus M needs to be explained. Is it needed? Or you can do it by yourself? Because in minus M, if attack will happen on para position, negative will come on this place. And if negative will come, you know, because it's a minus M, it will be very, very unstable situation. Like, why minus M effects are meta directing? Because if they are, let's say here also we consider that it is a group, NO2 group is there, let's say, minus M. And if it electrophiles attack here, so what you are going to get? Electrophile attack on this, attack on this. So you will get something like this. NO2 positive. Then it will undergo delocalization. You will get something like this. NO2 positive. NO2 positive, double bond like this. And electrophile presented. Very, very unstable. Very unstable situation. Why? Because positive is next to minus N group. It is already withdrawing the electron and carbon got the positive charge next to the NO2. Very, very unstable situation. Because NO2 is a minus N group and carbon attached to it is getting positive charge. So very, very unstable situation. That is why whenever there is a minus M group, we always write the attack will take place on meta position, not in ortho and para. Is it clear, students? Yes or no? Any doubt in this? Fine. So now what is about the reactivity? Benzene compound always favor the electrophilic substitution reaction and if there is a plus M group, it always favors the, you can say that, ortho and para position. So question, whenever you see this type of question, G group with electrophile, the product will be G and electrophile para position, G and electrophile ortho position. G with electrophile at ortho position. These will be the situation where G is plus M and plus I. Okay. Now, so students, let's say you have these type of reactions. Now, one thing is very clear that these are the, let's say you have this compound. Let's say you have this compound, benzene with benzene, the another benzene. Tell me where the electrophile will attack. Any idea? If electrophile is taken, where it will attack? Right? Whenever electrophile is taken in this ring, it will attack here. Right? It will attack here. This is called as KCP product. KCP, kinetically controlled product. And whenever it is like this, whenever it will attack on the next position, then it is thermodynamically controlled product. I will tell you why it is KCP and TCP. TCP, thermodynamically controlled product. Okay, TCP. Why it is like this, we will come to that. Fine. So this is the electrophile, how the electrophile will attack. Now, next is fine. So students, if you see, the question is like, if you have this type of situation, benzene ring, there is second benzene ring, and there is third benzene ring. Then where will attack? Then where your electrophile will attack? Any idea? Any idea? Where the electrophile will attack? Okay, it will attack on these two positions. Which two positions? These two positions. Electrophile will attack on these two positions. So the product will be this. Electrophile. Okay. So similarly, there are many other cases. Let's say this is one reaction. This is all because of the stability of uranium ion. I told you everything in the organic chemistry of aromatic compounds are decided by stability of uranium ion. Sir, which is the uranium ion? If you forgot the uranium ion, this is the uranium ion. Uranium ion is this. This ion which is forming after attack. After electrophilic attack, the ion which is forming is called as uranium ion. We see its stability. Okay, students, please write this thing. Later, otherwise you will forget. This is the uranium ion. Uranium ion. This, we will see the stability of this ion, and based on that, we will decide where the attack will happen. So let's say here, whenever these things, three rings are there, we won't break the aromaticity of these two rings, but there are two positions, all are symmetrical. So the attack will happen on these positions. Electrophile will attack on these positions. So the product will be benzene ring, and one more benzene ring, and your product will be something like this. Okay, the KCP and TCP and KCP comes like that in that compound only, not everywhere. Okay, if more than one group are present in aromatic ring. Now students,
okay, so how to know? Because when the electrophile attack on that place, the uranium ion which is going to form is most stable. This is the way to check whether attack will happen on which position. Okay, you need to draw the uranium ion and you will see that its stability. Okay, so here if attack will happen on this ring, okay, see, these are all the, this dashed position represents the benzylic carbon. Everywhere, wherever I put the dash, these are all the benzylic carbon. So attack will take place on benzylic carbon. Here also I will put the benzylic carbon.
This is also benzylic carbon. Benzylic carbon, whenever attack happens on this, the compound which you are going to get, if you, okay, see, one student has asked, sir, why, how to decide? I am going to take just one example, not more. I'm just going to take one example. Let's say attack happens on this position. Let's say attack happens on this position. Okay. So, so your positive will form somewhere here. Okay, Vaibhav, see here. This is going to form, right or wrong, when attack will happen on benzylic carbon. And let's say if attack will not happen on benzylic carbon, then this is the second product. This is the second possibility. One minute. Yes. So, just let me see. Positive. Electrophile is coming. So, here you are going to get the. Yes. So, positive will form here in one case. But if attack will happen there, positive will form in this position. Right? Positive will form here. Or you can say, if the attack will happen on meta position, electrophile will come here on meta position and positive will form here like this. Okay, done. Vaibhav, is it clear? There are two possibilities only, no third possibility. I told you benzylic position is favored. I said this is favored. Yes or no? Okay, first tell me, did you understand this part? What I explained? I'm taking this first example. Someone has asked, sir, why attack will happen on these positions? Why not on these positions? Why you are writing electrophile on these? Okay, this is a TCP product. TCP product is fine. But generally, we don't write TCP product. TCP means when you increase the temperature, then only product will form at this place. TCP means on increasing temperature. On increasing temperature, we will get this product. KCP means thermokinetically controlled product. Means if you don't increase temperature, this will be the product only. Attack won't happen at this position. So question is why? Why it is like this? So reason is, students tell me, if attack will happen on this position, there will be how many resonating structure you can draw? There are so many resonating structures. How? This positive is in extended delocalization with whole benzene ring. Right? Right? So see, there is a delocalization when we draw the delocalization. So, yes, I'm taking break. This is one resonance structure. This is one resonating structure. This is one resonating structure. Positive is present here. Negative is present here. There is one more resonating structure. There is one more resonating structure. Try to understand. When this negative will, this double bond will delocalize. Electron will come here. Double bond will form here. Positive will come here. Three possible resonance structure. Yes or no? If I keep one aromatic ring separate, three possible resonance structure. Now do for this. There is only one possible resonance structure because this positive and this double bond is not in delocalization at all. So resonance will take place between these only. Is it clear? Only one resonating structure. Your this positive won't have a resonance with double bond. Is it clear? So less resonating structure. Okay, I'm keeping the aromaticity of one compound intact. Kingshuk, I'm not breaking the aromaticity of one benzene ring. Then I'm comparing the stability of uranium ion. So you can see that arenium ion is more stable in this type of attack, when attack takes place at benzylic position. Is it clear to all of you? So attack will always take place on benzylic carbon. Yes, Vaibhav, I didn't receive your reply. Any doubt? Okay, so benzylic positions are always. So now students, we will have a break of 15 minutes, then we will continue at 6:20. We will start at 6:35.
Okay, students, am I audible? Fine. So whenever there is a attack, whenever the benzene ring will attack on electrophile, we will prefer the electrophile to attack on ortho benzylic position. Okay, students, there are some other points also which are important. Whenever you see any reaction taking place for benzene related compound, you need to take care of those things. Let's say here you have. Okay, fine. First question. If you have something like this, CH2 double bond CH2, is it an activating group? Is it an ortho para directing or not? Yes, tell me. Ortho para directing or not? Fine, meta directing, it's meta directing. Okay. Okay. So, okay, what about this? There is N double bond O. There is a lone pair also and O double bond O. Is it ortho para directing or not? And there is one more. SO, S double bond O, OH, ortho para directing or not? First. Then. Okay, fine. Students, tell me whether these are ortho para directing or not, or activating or deactivating. Quickly tell me. Ortho para directing or not, activating or deactivating. So fine, these are see, whenever there is a lone pair present on an atom, ortho para directing means, as I told you, that lone pair will stabilize the arenium ion. Whenever you have this chance that lone pair will stabilize the arenium ion, they are all ortho para directing. But here, since overall effect is minus M effect, they will create a minus M effect. So they are deactivating. Is it clear? Is it clear? Because their effect is minus M effect. So they are deactivating. Okay, ortho para directing, but they are deactivating. Why ortho para directing? Because they will stabilize the arenium ion. Ortho para directing and deactivating. Now, let's say you have this situation. Let's say you have this one. Fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine. Quickly tell me this you have learned last year. First, whether they are ortho para directing or not. Then, fine, they are ortho para directing, but activating or deactivating? Activating or deactivating? Whether they activate the ring towards the electrophilic aromatic substitution or deactivates the ring. Ortho para directing is because of the lone pair, but they are deactivating. Deactivating. Why deactivating? Because their minus I dominates. Because they have a minus I effect. Is it clear? It is. They have a minus I effect.
So students, in general, what you can write, in general, if there is a G plus M plus I, that is, G must not be halogen, G must not be halogen. In this case, ortho-para directing, as well as activating. But it is having a more reactivity than benzene ring. Your benzene will have a more reactivity than the halogen X or anything which is plus M. Because of that, it is ortho-para directing. Minus I, because of the due to the minus I, it deactivates the ring. Deactivating. Plus M is because of ortho-para directing, but their minus I dominates, like it's in halogen. They are ortho-para directing, no doubt. But the point is they are deactivating due to their minus I effect. And the last one is Y, where it has no lone pair. Last one is Y. This is meta directing and deactivating. Example, all minus M and minus I groups. This is a reactivity towards electrophilic substitution reaction. Yes. Minus I, okay, in case of halogens, it does not dominate. In case of halogen, it does not dominate. Minus I is more than minus M. Example, now, so one question can be asked like this. Quickly tell me what will be answer for this. If there is a CH3, there is CH3Cl, CH2Cl, and there is CH2, and there is CHCl2. Students, which all are ortho-para directing and activating, and which all are ortho-para directing deactivating? Quickly tell me. And the last one is this. CCl3. Answer this question. Ortho-para directing, activating, or deactivating like that? Activity decreases left to right. Very good. Fine. What about ortho-para directing thing? Which among them will direct the electrophile towards ortho and para position? Okay, Archit, last part is wrong. Okay, fine. Students, there is 3 hyperconjugation, 2 hyperconjugation, 1 hyperconjugation. And here you have a strong minus I, 0 hyperconjugation. No hyperconjugation. So due to hyperconjugation, it is ortho-para directing, meta-directing. Say it is more activating. So it is activating. I will represent it like big A. Activating will represent by big A. Big A, small a, more small a, it is actually deactivating. DA. Is it clear, students? Yes or no? Because CCl3, there is no hyperconjugation. Yes, negative hyperconjugation means definitely it is meta directing, right? So there is no hyperconjugation due to hydrogen. This means it is not ortho and para directing. Right? Okay. Fine. Yes, students,
there you can write where the TCP and KCP, which I told. TCP, I already told you, it takes place at high temperature.
TCP product is obtained at high temperature.
Okay, fine. Next is, so normal reactions which we discussed, when two groups are present, then when two groups are present, when two groups are present, here you have, let's say, you need to tell me where the electrophile will attack. Here it is, most activating or activating group is present like this. Most activating or activating group is present like this. Most activating and activating group is present like this. Activating and deactivating group are present like this. And activating and deactivating group is present like this. Yes, students, tell me in all these cases, if activating and deactivating group is present like this, where the electrophile will attack? Activating and deactivating group is present like, okay, fine. Most deactivating now. Most deactivating and deactivating group is present like this. Where the electrophile will attack? Within a benzene ring. Most deactivating and deactivating. And the last one, most deactivating and deactivating. Tell me, if electrophile wants to attack, where it will attack on these benzene rings? When two groups are present, MA represent most activating. Most activating. Like you have learned about the M effect. If NH2 is present, it has a more M effect. Most activating, let's say NH2. And less activating is, let's say, OH. It is less activating than NH2 group. If these two are present, then attack will happen on which carbon atom out of these four atoms? Students, once you finish it, say done. Done. It is one para, two, one. Okay, fine. Students, whenever this type of situation arises, we will decide by activating group. We won't decide by deactivating group. So here in first case, most activating is this, and this is activating group. Where the electrophile will attack? Where the electrophile will attack? Decided by most activating group. Okay, more activating group will decide. So it has either para, ortho position or para position. So tell me where attack will happen. Where attack will happen, either on this position or on this position. Yes or no? Any doubt? More activating, this or this. When it is like this, this is activating. There are three possibilities. But tell me which is the best possibility. Here, which is the best possibility? This is ortho of one, para of other. This is ortho of one and para of other. Will attack happen here? Will attack happen here? Ortho of both? Will attack happen here? Ortho of both? Okay, try to understand. According to this activating group, its ortho position is this. And its para position is this. According to this activating group, this is ortho position to its, and this is para position to its.
So these two positions, definitely there will be attack will happen. But will attack happen on this position? Will attack happen on this position? No. Why? Because it is hindered. So not possible. Hindrance. Similarly, we can say for every atom. Most activating, so ortho and para position, at these two places attack will happen. Though it is a meta for other group, though it is a meta for other activating group, but most activating will decide. In these two cases, when there is activating and deactivating, activating will decide. So activating will decide means either attack will take in on this position or in this position. No other position. Again, activating and deactivating, activating will decide. But when this activating will decide, either ortho position or para position. Ortho and para. But major one will be, okay, when it is like this, major one will be, which one? This is ortho, para. Okay, fine. When there is a A and D, attack can happen on these two positions, but not happen on this position because it is a ortho of other, ortho of one and ortho of other as well. Now students, which one will be the major one? Here you can say, this is a deactivating group. Deactivating group deactivates the position of ortho and para. So this is ortho, this is para. But according to this is ortho, this is para. So fine. Here you need to see the molecule, whether there is a hindrance or not. What about this? What about this? Attack will happen on ortho or para? Activating group, ortho position. Hope you understood this. Most deactivating will decide. So where the attack will happen? Tell me. Whenever most deactivating, so meta position of this. Either on this place or on this place. Any attack can happen on any place. Is it clear? Okay. Now in these two places also, where are the more chances to have attack? Where are the more chances to have attack? Tell me, out of these two. Okay, this is preferred one. So I will put up, this is preferred one. Here attack will happen because it is para to other. This deactivating group deactivates its para position. Okay. This deactivating group deactivates its para position or ortho position. But here the ortho position will have a little bit hindrance. Ortho position have a little bit hindrance. So that is why attack will happen on this place. More. What about this? Most deactivating. Most deactivating will decide. So attack will happen on this. Meta to most deactivating. Okay. No other position. Here also, this and this, most deactivating will decide. These two positions will be the equivalent position where attack can take place. Is it clear, students? Yes or no? Any doubt in this? Fine. So students, this is about the activating and deactivating. Now, last year you have learned all those reactions which I am not going to cover is halogenation. Students, halogenation, you know that general reaction of halogenation reaction, benzene ring reacts with anhydrous AlCl3 gives chlorine and HCl. So I'm not going to discuss that again, the mechanism and all. You all know this thing, halogenation. I'm not going to discuss. Okay, one question, like why iodination is reversible. So HIO3 and all these are formed, that is why iodination is reversible. First, those things you need to remember. Second is sulfonation. I am not going to discuss, which you have already learned last year. Sulfonation. Not going to discuss.
Okay. What is the electrophile in sulfonation? Just tell me this thing.
Electrophile in sulfonation. Anyone? SO3 is a electrophile, not H2SO4. Electrophile is SO3. Okay. Fine. So next is,
you can take oleum and all.
Okay. So fine. Next point is, okay, if you want me, I will directly write the equation. In sulfonation, what happens? There is a benzene ring, concentrated H2SO4. And you will get heating, you will get sulfonic acid. That's it. SO3H.
Fine. Next is
desulfonation. I will discuss. I think you have not discussed the desulfonation part. What is desulfonation? So, students, I am skipping some parts because you have learned last year. Skipping means I am not telling you the mechanism and all. So, desulfonation means if there is a SO3H group, and if you use dilute H2SO4, dilute HCl or steam, what will happen? This SO3H is a very good leaving group. This will depart and you will get a benzene ring. This is called as desulfonation. Okay, but if you use concentrated H2SO4, what will be the product? You tell me. If it is a concentrated H2SO4, what will be the product?
Any idea?
Where it will attach? Very good, Archit. Think so, correct answer. Because SO3H is a deactivating group. SO3H is a deactivating group. Students, how to decide activating and deactivating? I think someday I told you, lone pair is present means it is activating. Lone pair is present means it is a plus M. And double bond is there, it means minus M. So based on that, you will decide ortho and para directing. Here you don't have any lone pair. Sulfur has a double bond, so it is a meta directing. SO3H has this structure. There is no lone pair. SO3H. This structure, there is no lone pair, so it is meta directing. So SO3H will form. Is it clear, students?
Yes or no?
Okay, do one question. Do one question. This question is asked. Like, we have this bromobenzene, we have toluene. We have toluene, but I want only bromobenzene. I want bromine substituted only at para position, or let's say only at ortho position. Only ortho, only product. Is it possible to get that? Is it possible to get that using this above equation? Whatever I explained in sulfonation part. Think and write the answer. Done. No, Ruchita, no. Think, not possible. Hydrogen bonding is not possible in that. Could you repeat the lone pair double bond thing? Okay. Whenever there is a double bond, if this is attached to a benzene ring, how to check whether the group is ortho para directing or meta directing? If this sulfur atom has a lone pair, it is ortho para directing. If it is not, if it is having just double bond, then it is meta directing. Meta directing for double bond, ortho para directing for lone pair. If it has a lone pair and double bond, then it will be off. Then also it will be ortho para directing but deactivating group. Remember, I took the example of NO. NO has a double bond and lone pair both. Student, just a minute. I will go to the previous slide. Those who don't have clarity on this, ortho para directing and this thing. I told you this part. See, here you have HSO3. They are ortho para directing. Why? Because they have a lone pair. But they are also bonded with double bond. That is why they are deactivating. If they don't have double bond, we could have said that they are activating as well as ortho para directing. Lone pair tells that ortho para directing because they will stabilize the positive which will come here during the arrhenium ion formation. They will stabilize this positive charge by donating their lone pair. That is why they are called as ortho para directing whenever there is a lone pair. But whether they are activating or not, it will be decided by whether they are bonded with the electronegative atom or not. If they are bonded with oxygen and double bond, it is a strong minus I group, strong minus I. So minus I means it will be deactivating. I hope it is clear. Now, student, this question, a very easy question I have asked. Now, how to use this equation, the above equation? As I told you, desulfonation is used. So how to get this? Actually, first it is reacting with H2SO4. H2SO4, SO3 is an electrophile, will attack on ortho and para position. But since para position is major, so I will write SO3H will attack here. Because it is a very big group. Sulfonation gives a major product at para position. Because it is a very big group. Now, once the SO3H will reach this position, what you can carry out after this? Any idea? Yes, tell me. Halogenation. Very good. So when you carry out the halogenation at this place, what you are going to get? Okay, you can reuse Br2/Fe. Halogenation. Where the bromine will attack? Activating group, deactivating group, activating and deactivating. Who will decide? Activating will decide. Activating and deactivating group, both are present. Activating will decide. Attack will happen on these two positions. Bromine will attack here. CH3, Br, SO3H. In next step, what should we do? Tell me fast. What should we do so that we get this? Desulfonation. Heat. Steam. Heating in presence of steam. Okay? So, when you heat, it is a desulfonation. Is it clear? So this reaction is used to block the para position. Sulfonation is many times it is carried out to block the para position. Why para sulfonate is only product? Because SO3 is a very big group. When it attacks here, it is very, very unstable. It will go to the para position fast. Because it is very big group, ortho creates a hindrance. What else? Sir, FCS3 ortho para directing, why didn't we just brominate? Ortho para directing, if you brominate, you will get the product at ortho and para. I ask you, only product I need para. I need only ortho product. Kingshook. That was my question. Okay, fine. So, this is a normal. Okay, we will do some other sulfonation reactions also. Students, which will come in other compounds. Let's say you have this reaction. OH, okay, first thing. If you have a CH3, a very interesting question I'm going to ask. CH3 and D2O and D2SO4. D2O and D2SO4, what will be the product? If you have OH phenol reaction with D2O and D2SO4, what will be the product? Fine. Students, dilute D2SO4. D2O with D2SO4 tells you that dilute D2SO4. Dilute sulfuric acid. Dilute sulfuric acid as an electrophile. Dilute H2SO4 as electrophile H+. Dilute D2SO4 as a electrophile D+. The product will be D+ is electrophile. What will be the product? D and D. Yes? Yes or no? Fine. Okay. Next is here. If you have a phenol, okay, leave the second question. Later I will take the second question, not now. First, let me explain a simple sulfonation thing. If you have this with concentrated H2SO4, tell me what will be the product. Here you have 15 to 25 degrees Celsius, and in next case, concentrated H2SO4 at 125 degrees Celsius. Student, this question will come in your phenol chapter. Done. Fine. Here you have a concentrated H2SO4, phenol, SO3H. SO3 will be electrophile. Product will be, because it is a ortho para directing, at ortho attack will take place, OH. SO3H at low temperature. Why? Can anyone tell me why? Sir, you only told that SO3H won't attack in ortho position, but why you are writing like this? If someone is wondering, so tell me why I have written SO3H at this position. Very good, Weber. Correct answer. Why I have written SO3H at this position? Kingshuk, correct answer. Because this SO3H forms, this SO3H forms hydrogen bonding. This SO3H forms hydrogen bonding with intramolecular hydrogen bonding. What? That is why it's stable. Intramolecular H bonding. That is why it is stable. But if you have concentrated H2SO4 at high temperature, this bonding will break. This intramolecular hydrogen bonding will break. Your OH will form and SO3H will come at the para position. Is it clear, students? Yes or no? Any doubt? Because at high temperature, bond will break. Now, student, a very interesting question I have given you. You need to think like if you have normal this compound with Br2 and Fe, what will be the product?
a very interesting question which will clear all your doubts about the plus M, minus M, ortho, para, directing, whatever things. Done. This question will come in your nitrogen containing compound chapter. Fine, students, I will tell you. Students, whenever there is a, you get confused here, sir, Br plus will be the electrophile. Now, where it will attack? So, students, oxygen has a lone pair. So, it will be ortho para directing, activating also, because it is having plus M. And carbon is bonded with oxygen, it is having a minus M. I told you to detect the plus M and minus M. Plus M will be having a lone pair. Minus M will have a double bond. So this is a deactivating ring. This ring get deactivated. This is an activated ring. And activated ring, ortho and para will be the product. But since there is a huge hindrance around the ortho position, attack will take place on para. And product will be this. Product will be C, double bond, O, O, this, 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 this. Anyone got this answer? Anyone has written this answer? So there are two, three concepts. Very good, Gayatri. There are two, three concepts you need to see. One is plus M and minus M, both are present. Then where the attack will happen? Either it's ortho position or para position. So para will be favored because it has a less hindrance. So on para, Br will form, major product. No doubt ortho will be also there, but that will not be the major. Okay, next reaction, sulfonation of amines. Very, very important. Always remember, whenever you see aniline and phenol, they will have somewhat some exception. They won't show reaction as usual we get for toluene. They will show some different reaction whenever aniline and phenol comes in electrophilic substitution reaction. Fine, students, done. This is a base. Don't think that electrophilic aromatic substitution will take place. If you have written it electrophilic aromatic substitution, then you are wrong, because I told you acid base reactions are fastest. So the product will be NH3 plus SO4, HSO4 minus. How many of you have written this? Anyone? Anyone who has written this? Oh, very good. Kingshuk. HSO4 minus acid base reaction. In next step, if you heat at 200 degrees Celsius, then you might get the product which you have expected. Then you get your product which you have expected, that NH2 and SO3H will come at this place. Is it clear, students? Any doubt in this? Okay. Fine. So next is, this is the reaction. Okay, one student asked this, sir, what happens in desulfonation? Which type of mechanism? Students, the desulfonation mechanism, I will tell you. Mechanism of desulfonation is called as ipso attack. Ipso attack. What is ipso attack? There is SO3H and H plus reacts with in presence of water, because you have taken H plus in presence of water. What happens? This electron ipso attack means attack on preoccupied position. Attack on preoccupied position is called as ipso attack. So it will take the new electrophile, that is H plus. But this atom only will attack, not its ortho or para, anything. This is called as ipso attack. Okay, so your this SO3H will be present here. Okay, hydrogen will come,
hydrogen will come like this, and there will be positive charge. After some time, since this is called a sigma complex or arenium complex, arenium ion is also called a sigma complex. Okay, I can write here sigma complex. Now what will happen? Since SO3H is a good, SO3 is a good leaving group, it will say, okay, I'm going, you stay here. I'm going means I will give my electron to this, right? So what will happen here? You will get SO3 benzene ring. You will get a benzene ring along with SO3H plus. In next step, it will lose H plus. You will get SO3 gas. So this is called as electrophilic ipso attack. Electrophilic ipso attack. Okay, right here, desulfonation is a type of. This is a electrophilic ipso attack, or you can write here, ipso attack. Okay, sir, can there be any nucleophilic ipso attack? Yes, there is something called as nucleophilic ipso attack, right? Next thing. In these are all under the sulfonation topic only. Next is nucleophilic ipso attack. What is that? In nucleophilic ipso attack, you have, let's say, nucleophile. Same thing, SO3H will be there. SO3H will be there, nucleophile will come and attack. So, one minute. Here you have nucleophile. Let's say you use any OH. If you use any OH, your nucleophile can also attack. Okay, very specific reaction. Don't apply it everywhere. What happens? First, any OH is taken. So, acid-base reaction will take place. Acid-base reaction will take place, so it will form SO3 minus. First is acid-base reaction. Okay. Once acid-base reaction takes place, after that, what will happen? Here your NaOH is present. And this OH minus will attack on this position. And when it will attack on this position, instead of, okay, fine. What will happen? This electron will shift on this position. In next step, instead of getting positive charge, here you are getting negative charge because it is nucleophilic ipso attack. Attack is taking place on that atom only where the leaving group is present, SO3 minus. Like this, SO3 minus. There is a OH also present. This. In next step, because it is a strong electronegative atom, and a good leaving group, this will go like this. And the product obtained will be this. You will get phenol. Oh my God. Students, this is one of the technique to prepare phenol. You will learn in NCRT, but no one will tell you that this is ipso attack or whatever attack. But I think now you can easily make it out that phenol is prepared by nucleophilic ipso attack from SO3H. So if someone say, write the product, students, can you write the product? Quickly tell me what will be the product if KCN is used. Don't go through the full mechanism. Just write the final product and tell, sir, done. Once you write, say done. Fine. How many of you have done this product? How many of you have written this? Very good, Ruchita, Piksho, Kripu, Anirudh, Gayatri. Very good. Very easy one, right? Next is, now students, next reaction is nitration. You tell me, student, what is nitration mixture? Nitration mixture is? Yes. Nitration mixture is? You have already learned this last year. But I am taking all these reactions for phenol and aniline. Nitration. For nitration, the reactants are First, the general reaction. This is general reaction. Concentrated HNO3. Concentrated HNO3 and H2SO4. HNO3 and concentrated H2SO4. Nitration mixture. And you will get a nitrobenzene. This you learned last year. Okay. So here, if someone wants to know how electrophile is generated, first step is always electrophile generation. So first step is generation of electrophile. Generation of electrophile. Okay, sir. We know that how it is generated, but still I will tell you those who don't know this. Because concentrated H2SO4 is a strong acid, it behaves like an acid, it will take, and your nitric acid will behave like base. Nitric acid will behave like base, and acid-base reaction will take place. You will get HHONO2. Acid-base reaction will take place. You will get this positive here. In next step, oxygen is getting positive. Oxygen will say, okay, bye, I'm leaving as a water. And NO2 plus will be the electrophile. If anyone wants to know how electrophile is generated, this is the process. NO2 plus is the electrophile. Okay. Now, what all other reagents can be used? Reagents can be anything else also. Reagent can be only concentrated HNO3. Reagent can be, this is B part, B reagent. C reagent is HClO4 and HNO3. Sometimes this is also written in textbooks. D, HNO2 in presence of HNO3. Very rarely these are written. Most of the time you will see the A part only. But these are also the reagent. Sometimes it is written dilute HNO3 also. Dilute HNO3. But dilute HNO3 work for phenol. For phenol nitration mixture is dilute HNO3 also. Because phenol is highly activated ring. You don't need concentrated HNO3. So these are the few things which are given as a this thing. Sometimes, you know, very interesting thing. If someone wants to, sometimes it is also given NO2F plus BF3. So NO2F plus BF3 is nothing but it is NO2 plus and BF4 minus. So it is also giving you the NO2 plus electrophile. So overall, we want NO2 plus electrophile. That is why this whole thing is going on. Okay, let us start doing the questions in nitration thing. Students, normal nitration is this. If you have benzene ring, nitration can, okay, fine. Tell me, students, if you use concentrated HNO3 and conc H2SO4, no doubt the nitration will give you this product. No doubt. But this reaction takes place at 60 degrees Celsius. But if you carry out this reaction at 90 degrees Celsius, can you tell me what will be the product? And if you carry out this reaction at 120 degrees Celsius, what will be the product? Done. If you increase the temperature, no idea. Students, think, okay, fine. I will help you a little bit. This thing will further react. This thing will react with NO2 at high temperatures. The product formed in first reaction will further react. Tell me, it will direct NO2 to which position? This compound A will direct NO2 to which position? Very good, Ruchita, correct answer. Gayatri, correct answer. Kingshok, wrong answer. Archit, correct answer. NO2 is a deactivating group. NO2 is a deactivating group. Ring become highly deactivated
but the temperature will help for further reaction. High temperature will help for further reaction, and the deactivating group is always Stuti. Correct, wrong answer, because NO2 is a deactivating group. It will attack will happen on meta position. The best position for electrophile when any deactivating group is present, because electrophile does not want to go on those positions which are highly deactivated. Ortho and para positions are highly deactivated due to this NO2. But in meta position, there is only minus I effect of NO2 is acting. That is why your electrophile attacks on meta position. Stuti and Kingshuk, did you understand? Yes or no? Not Stuti. Stuti only. Fine. What will happen at more high temperature? Tell me. Now it become a very, very highly deactivated ring. But still, if you increase the temperature, then your this compound will further react. Both are same. Now think, deactivating and deactivating, both are same. Very good, Ruchita, correct answer. Archit, correct answer. Gayatri, correct answer. Fine. Students, one more meta position will be occupied by NO2. Is it clear? Yes or no? Let us have one question. If you have this reaction, toluene. If toluene is reacting with concentrated HNO3 plus concentrated H2SO4, that A compound is formed. Then it is reacting with alkaline KMNO4. Alkaline KMNO4 gives B compound, which will react with NaOH and CaO. NaOH and CaO gives compound C. Predict ABC. Predict A, B, and C. Done. Fine. So students, answer of first question is concentrated HNO3 you have taken. Okay. So here the product obtained will be, you need to do one by one step. So concentrated HNO3. So can I say nitration mixture, CS3 is taken. So what is going to form? Okay, can I say, how many of you have written this? CS3, NO2, NO2, and NO2. How many of you have written this? Trinitrotoluene. In next step, alkaline KMNO4, today only we discussed, whenever next to benzene ring, if there is a methyl group, that will oxidize to carboxylic acid.
Today, in today's class only we discuss NO2. That is by alkaline K1O4. In next step, NaOH and CaO. Which reagent is this? Soda lime. Remember soda lime. Soda lime do what? What is the purpose of soda lime? Decarboxylation. Decarboxylation, not E2. Decarboxylation. COH group will be removed. Ah, yes. No. Mechanism of soda lime is EI mechanism. Remember? EI. Last thing which we discussed. Not E2. NO2. Intermolecular elimination reaction. Intramolecular. So this is the answer. How many of you got all the three answers right? A, B, C? Just write me. Fine. Okay. So intramolecular elimination, soda lime, COH will be removed. Yes, students, what will be the product of next two reactions?
These are the last questions of today's class.
Okay, as I told you, whenever aniline and phenol will come, reaction won't be as simple as you have expected. So I will write for first. You have expected, okay, sir, NO2 will come. NO2 will form everywhere. But the point is, the product of the first reaction is NH2, para position NO2, 51%. NO2 at para position is 51%. Okay. NO2 at meta position. NO2 will come here also, some product. And NO2 will form some ortho product also. It is 2%. Your meta percentage will increase. Meta will be 41%. Okay, sir. Why, sir? If someone is thinking why it happens, students, why not acid-base reaction? Yes. Actually, first only acid-base reaction going to take place. First acid-base reaction takes place. So you will get NH3+. Okay. Student, first acid-base reaction will take place so that you get NH3+. Any doubt? Because this is base, this is acid. But what happens after that? This become a deactivating group. And once it become earlier it was activating group, NS as a lone pair. So once it become a deactivating group as well as meta directing, because there is no lone pair left with it, it become meta directing. That is why your meta product is huge. Is it clear, students? Yes or no? Sir, but why not leaving group? Where is the leaving group, my dear? But why not leaving group? Where is leaving group? How NS3 will leave? No. Double bond characteristics. Double bond characteristics. How it will leave? I told you, substitution reaction is not possible in benzene. Very few examples are there. Ipso attack is one of the substitution reaction of nucleophile. Otherwise, everything is electrophilic substitution. And electrophilic substitution takes place at ortho and para position. Why you are going to have a ipso attack here? Ipso is just for SO3H. Is it clear? So these are the exceptions. Whenever aniline phenol will come, they will show some exceptions. Okay, fine. Student, what is answer of 2? This is the last question. I will write. The one product, because phenol OH is a highly activating group, okay, the one product is this. 2,4,6-trinitrophenol. No doubt, but it is a minor. This is minor. This is also called as picric acid. Picric acid is a minor product, but the major product is this. Oxidation is the major product. You know, the phenol will get oxidized. no one has thought that concentrated HNO3 act as oxidizing agent also. No one has thought that. Okay, fine. Webber, very good question you have asked. Very good question you have asked that, sir, why even para product is formed? Why even para product is formed? Because your amine is not that strong base that reaction goes always in forward direction. It is having an equilibrium with NS3 also. Like this is an equilibrium reaction. Don't think everything become NS4 plus because it is not very strong base. So most of the part is ammonia only. Is it clear? Reaction is mostly toward backward direction. So students, these are the compound which are going to form. Okay, please remember all these things. These are very important. Okay, now students, I am telling you very important thing. Now, after few minutes, you will see the assignment allotted to you for reduction and oxidation reactions. Please complete your assignment without fail, and I will put comment after checking your assignment before next class. Don't forget to submit your assignment. That's all for today. Thank you. Bye. Have a nice day. If you have any doubt, you can stay back. Okay, students, thank you.